Well, hello everybody. Welcome back to another wonderful day of Sharlenwar's adventure in 7 days to die. Woo! What's going on? What's going on today? Well, right now we are in our base. I did have these iron bars set up because I wanted to kind of use them. We're going to have this iron here. We're going to basically add to the spikes on the outside. So today is going to be kind of hanging around the house during the dog horde day type of thing. And right now I'm going to go down here. I've changed our home point to this place right here, and I hear walking outside. Oh boy, do I hear walking. Woot woot woot. Let's go down this way. And do we have any wood? I should maybe grab some wood here. Whoop. Whoa, okay, that's no good. I'm trying to kind of play with some mechanics here. What's going on? There we go. This is why you don't want to put the ladder where this is. It's just, it's a real pain in the butt. Throw the spikes in here. Keep the wood ones on us. Any wood frames in here? I thought there was some wood frames in here, but maybe not. I know that there's some stone here. So I'll throw that on us. I'll grab the clay. Well, I don't know if I need the clay. And, okay, so let's do this. Let's do this. So I will come back when it's daytime. Okay, so here we are. Hear that noise? That's a zombie. Let's take a look at food here, just to make sure we're okay. We're doing really well. What's our skills at? We have 12 points available. I don't think there's anything that we can really purchase here on the fly. I think we have pretty much everything we need. What we need to do is get our scavenging up, really. Now there's that fire zombie that we hear. I wonder if he's inside or outside. Hello, dude. Or is it a dead one? It's probably a dead one. So this, see, there's all these spikes here that we need to, woo, to place and do. So we do need the wood frames. I was wondering if I should have those. So let's just run on back inside here like a silly person. I was worried about that burning noise, but the reality is it's really, that's nothing. Now, we do have dog hordes, so we do have to be aware of that. They haven't come yet. So, yeah, so let's grab the wood frames. Well, I have a little bit of spikes. Let's grab some wood. I'm going to need a whole bunch, I think, is what it looks like. So let's make some wood spikes. I should make a claw hammer as well since we're in here, so can I make 100 of these? Yeah, 100 would be okay. Claw hammer. Claw hammer, I think, takes some forged iron here. Let's go claw. This would be better to use to upgrade. Okay, and let's just throw this stuff back in there. Okay, now we also have 32 iron bars. It's not very many, but enough. So what I want to do is kind of place these iron bars on the corner over here, I think. I think this is the corner I want to get attacked by, potentially. So in order to do that, we have to basically pick up one of these wood frames and do this. Left click, I think. Yes, left click does this. It rotates. Let's find the happy medium. I can do them like that. Or the other way. It probably doesn't matter. I want them all going the same way. And we basically just do this. This way we can run along on top of these. All right, we also have to harvest our farm there. It looks very nice and big. So that's definitely a must. But so it looks like for the next couple days we're going to have to work hard at upgrading our base here, our wall here, to the next kind of stage of concrete. And that should be enough. I think that will handle the rest of the hordes from here on out. So I'm kind of excited for that. But man, these are going so fast. And I know I have the iron on me, but that's because we need to put them on the spikes. Now, do we have two rows here or one row of spikes only? I only see one row. We might have to change that. I thought we wanted two rows of spikes on the outside. So I don't know. And the thing with these rebar frames is once you place them, that's it, they're placed. So yeah, so we're going to have these go out, two out, I think. Just so that way we have enough room to run around on them. Man, oh man, oh man. So now we gotta contend with the dogs. So let's see here. So I think I'm gonna throw a bunch of stuff into our inventory here. Because I'm gonna go on that harvesting spree. We should put some pain pills here as well. And if we really have to, we can always activate the first aid kit. So let's hurry and run around here. Potato seeds. We need to make 10 of these. Man, so I think this is the worst part about farming is this part of it. We need to pick up the cotton or the corn, of course, because the worst part of it is, especially dog horde day, I'm kind of tempting the fates. I'm trying to listen for them as well. Blueberry seeds. We're gonna turn them all into seeds. Corn. We want 10 of these bad boys. All right, craft. And let's replant these. Come on, come on, let's do this. It's pretty intense, hey? Farming on the dog horde day. Let's actually put the corn seeds here. And I just kind of right-click as I move, because it doesn't matter. It won't place it if you're too close to it. And then the potatoes. Perfect, okay. So now what I was going to do is I was actually going to use the wood frames and I was going to kind of make a bridge. It's higher than I expected it to be, but I wanted to make a bridge. Oh, shit. Ouch. That's bad. Oh, I got to use one of these stupid bandages because of a stupid mistake. And then I got to take some pain pills. Man, I hate this. Hate working on spikes. You want to crouch? For some reason, standing, it doesn't let you place them. So there's, oh yeah, there's spike on top. And then we go down a step. There we go. So see all these spikes here? So we need another row of these, I think, because we want two rows of them. Right? And kind of like this. And we just place them all the way around. Let's see. Yeah. That's interesting. Hey, it goes up. We might want to dig this out. Okay, no, here we go. We're back to normal now. Okay, perfect. Wrench. We need the wrench. Actually, we have the hammer. Who cares about the wrench? The wrench is for dismantling. Hammer would be for repairing. Look at that. Okay, cool. I like that. Let's repair this stuff. Ah, come on. Working with spikes. That's always fun. Oh, wow. Just one shot to repair. Okay. Wow. Look at that. Dying by my own spikes. That's wonderful. Okay, hopefully they don't use that as a way to get up, because that would be very, very, very bad. Let's put our bow away, because we're not going to shoot at any of them. Okay, let's jump up here. Let's fill these up here. Because we obviously know that we have to replenish the spikes. Okay, we'll just have to reevaluate this in a little while. Look, that stuff looks like needs repairing. Yeah. Interesting. Okay, everything should be repaired. Okay, some more spikes here. Whew. Tempting fate here with the dogs. Let's kind of crouch. One, two, perfect. Okay, so this side's kind of patched up. I'm gonna run inside here. That's a little bit intense. A little bit intense. Let's see, what else do we need to do? I think that's the major sides patched up. This dog horde day kind of makes things useless in general. But yeah. That's fine and dandy. Let's close the door on that. Cool, so I'm going to do some inventory management, and so I'll meet you back up here. Okay, so after evaluating things a little bit, I notice here on this side, things are a little bit skimpy, so we're going to have to repair all of this. Now, what is the best way of doing that? It's probably just doing the wood frame method, which kind of stinks. And I'll have to do it along there. So for probably the next day after this one, for day 27, I'm thinking it's going to be a hardcore harvesting run right from 4 a.m. till the evening. It's just going to be non-stop harvesting of, I think, the rocks in this biome over here. Basically, I'm going to need to stay in this biome and just kind of cover the entire biome and just go after all those rocks and just keep going after it all day long. So it's going to be very boring. Not much to really report on that one. I'll be going around killing zombies along the way as well, of course. But yeah, that's I think what it is. And then we'll have to repair kind of our stuff around our base here. Yeah. So yeah, so that's what I've been thinking about. And nothing else interesting. The dog horde has not arrived yet. I'm waiting for it patiently. But I'm kind of getting impatient. We kind of need to fix this stuff here. So let's hop out. Let's kind of maybe like this. Maybe you don't have to actually get on the ground, just need to get close enough to replace stuff. Now we want to put two rows of these spikes at some point, I imagine, right? And then we can probably use hammer. Let's see, how far can we reach? Woo! Okay, nice. Okay. I'll repair any of these things along the way. Doesn't hurt. Alright. Okay, cool. And basically what I would do is just carry on with these things and just move along. Hopefully no dogs come. Basically that's kind of what we're hoping for, because this unfortunately needs to get done. I guess if dogs did come, we would just run for our ladder, probably just right through the spikes and everything. Who cares? So let's see here. Let's do that. Your doggies? No, it's probably just my imagination. Ooh, one too far. Not spikes, just these things. And we just carry them on like this in the intensity of it all. Okay, and just bang. Yeah, whatever. Perfect. Okay, so these are somewhat repaired. Let's back this up. Hello, zombie. They're kind of messing up my spikes. Okay, and like so. Whew. Okay. That was successful. So now there's another spot. Man, this is going to be scary. So over along here, I kind of want to go and upgrade. We got 394 iron. All these spikes here are kind of foobard. These need bad repairs, mad repairs. Construction's at 97, so that's almost maxed up. And then we'll be, yeah, we're going to have a hard time leveling up soon. Because I think once we go through the easy stuff, we need to figure out what to do to increase the other skills. I'm just going to go run back inside here. I tell you what, I think that's going to be about it for this whole episode. It's a very short episode. Probably going to just slap some multiplayer content on, I'm thinking. If not, I'll cut this part out. Anyways, folks, I'm just going to be hanging around here doing what we do. Going to chop this tree down. Maybe harvest the rest of the garden. I'm not too sure. I have a garden kit ready in here. Like I got some 10 seeds of each of the crop that we have, except for the cotton, of course. So I'll have to probably create that. But thank you everybody for watching. Hopefully you've enjoyed this episode, and I look forward to seeing you in the next one. Bye bye. Oh, my athletics is now 37. Woohoo.
That's why Dropbox chess is best, right? You push everything into the chest and you just go, everyone goes R, and you should be able to take everything back, right?
Hopefully.
Everything will auto stack, so.
Are you dead? This person's dead over here. You kill this person already?
Oh, yeah, I couldn't. I don't know, maybe. I thought that was an actual walking
one. Let me look for seats. No.
Did you hit it?
Uber. No, I just walked up.
There you go. It's untouched.
One, two, three, four. Yeah, five crosses.
Weird. That was really weird. I was just hanging out next to it. It wasn't even doing anything.
So I'm gonna say.
Man, this game is so weird.
It's alpha.
Yeah.
I guess corn's like the most important.
He was just lonely.
Iron arrowheads, cool. I could use those.
You guys already run the circumference of the town?
Nope.
I did a little bit earlier, but no. I didn't feel very safe alone.
Yeah. Jump over here.
But now you can.
Might be a gun safe.
Now if I go iron. I'm out of that chest. There shouldn't be any dogs.
That dog right there?
I'm gonna put more wood in this chest. No. Now there's 500.
You got blunderbuss too.
That's true, I do got a blunderbuss.
Oh, I don't want these bullets.
Should be fine.
Graveyard. And someone's duffel bag out.
So which direction do you want to go?
Whichever.
Whichever?
I've been both, so whichever. Oh,
okay, I was going to go...
But, I mean, this way?
That's yeah, fine. I was going to go this way.
This is, like, the edge of town. Well,
you guys know about
town.
The tombstones that you could dig up?
Mm-hmm, there should be a coffin in there somewhere, yeah. If you dig down from where the gravestone is, there should be a coffin or so.
Yeah.
Wow, that's a cool building.
Isn't that, like, the sewage treatment or something?
Well, there's more cars, too, in there. Where's the way?
There's a lot of cars in there. That's worth going in.
Okay.
But it won't be sewage treatment if there's cars in there.
Oh, man, that's the easy way in.
Through the fence.
Here, this is the way in right here.
Yeah.
The easiest.
Honey.
Yeah.
Like that.
Forgot what I was gonna
do. Just gotta be careful. This is interesting. Oh yeah, of course there's a zombie in here. Hello.
Mad Mole's grave.
Mad Mole.
Yeah, if you dig up Mad Mole's grave, he has stuff in it.
Okay. How do you know whose is Mad Mole's grave?
Says it? Oh, it's just glue? Not in this one. It says it on the tombstone.
Hmm.
There's the squarish, blocky tombstones.
Okay.
Dig it up. And sometimes you find good stuff in them.
Oh, I found a potato seed. This is an interesting structure, too, like, building-wise.
Yeah,
throw some spice definitely.
Here.
Okay. Desk, garbage. Oh, that's a book of some sort. Pistol book.
It's a book.
Should save that for me.
Okay.
Since I got the highest gunsmithing right now.
Gotcha.
Oh. Mine's at 50 now, so. But whatever you want, it doesn't matter.
No, it's fine. I have it in my inventory here, so.
Yeah. You need to read it to make room or whatever.
Then I'll bring it back.
See, normally upgrading the bottom layer wouldn't matter, but because now these spikes make them crawl.
Oh,
zombies,
this has stairs going more. Down in here.
Aye.
Ew.
Not you, it's cool.
Really gross down here, though.
Oh, come on. Why, this is so cool. There's like a whole area down here.
This is like the place that Jace was all like, oh, this is going to be the safest place for us to be. And then
the horde came in through the ceiling
above us here.
Yeah, it wasn't that safe. We have bad memories of that.
Because they probably went through there's a duct cover, right?
Oh, cool,
they probably went through that.
There's a box in here.
Probably.
There's this right here. We're working stiff's
off,
crates.
Okay.
But we can already search it, though. Oh, there's another engine. Good.
Oh, I found a jacket. I should probably actually put that on since I'm so cold.
Okay,
wow,
I need
to
jump
up. Wow,
it's
weird that you're that cold.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't understand. I'm here too. And it's women,
I'm
I tell
like
you.
I'm at like 83. Where
I'm 45.
And I'm at 57.
But I've got like a lot of iron and iron armor, and that even makes you cold too. That's weird.
Yeah.
Did you take like one of those T-shirts that we?
Yeah,
had?
I had put a tank top on. So.
Ooh. Like, what's your total insulation value?
Go into your character panel, yeah. Your character on the left, you'll see it's like a thermometer.
Like
it says plus whatever.
+21.
Huh.
I have a jacket on now.
I'm at +3 degrees Fahrenheit. Oh, there's another way into here. That's why they came in here.
That's funny. I'm at +9, and you guys are in the city biome. You can't be in the city biome. There's no way. Uh-oh.
Oh.
Where's that?
What's uh-oh?
That flew, like, right over me.
The plane?
So does that mean the drop is, like, nearby here?
Maybe. Or at least somewhere I don't see.
No, it's way out there. Forget that.
Not seeing
I'm
the
outside,
smoke
but I don't see no plane, so...
No, it flew right over our base.
So it was for one of you guys?
Yeah, but it dropped, like, it's pretty far, actually, so I'm not going to bother. Actually, if I look at it, it dropped south.
I might be able to get
so,
it.
South of the base, pretty much. South, maybe south. South, southeast,
back.
Maybe. Kind of pointed towards where that watering hole is.
Yeah, okay. On. So near your bunker base.
So in that line. In that line is where it's
so. I'm heading that
maybe,
way.
Yeah, maybe you keep going.
I gotta
straight.
Head back to base anyway, so
you
I'm
might find
it.
Yeah.
I need to drop stuff off.
Oh shit! Oh.
Ow!
How'd you die? Oh no, wait.
I fell on the spikes while I was upgrading.
Leg.
I think there's still some issues with the wood frames. I think I fell through one of the wood frames.
Mm.
And I couldn't jump back on it.
So kind of like what happens to me sometimes. Okay, so
thanks, Drew. Thanks for the kind comments. You're Andrew Ford saying hi.
Nice.
Can't stay long, but he wanted to drop in and say hello.
It's cool when people do that, when they drop in say hello.
It yep. is.
How's your looting? You're going evil giraffe-y?
Fine.
Still down in the basement there, or...?
No, I'm out of it.
Okay,
out
cool.
Of it now.
I'm just dropping stuff off at the chest here.
I went all the way to the roof and got everything out of the building. Not that there's much. But there's
Nursing?
This other room, and it has a basement.
Nurse?
Yeah, it goes down Nurse? Into the other part. That's probably how you got ambushed by the zombies, probably. Thinking you're all secured up, and then there was like a back entrance.
Yeah.
Classic.
If you built like spikes and walls and reinforced the whole wall, like on the outside, right, then it would
well,
work
that's
good.
Well, same thing with the sewage plant. There's like outside of the wall, there's like a little plate that if you break it, it goes right into the sewage plant, and zombies can get in through there. And it's kind of funny when people don't know about that, and then that happens to them.
I think they did that on purpose that way when you go there, and if you don't know about it.
Like, we know by it, it's a good way to get in, because it's easy.
Yeah. When you don't know about it. So are you down
if
in
you
here, too, or you went out?
Sure. That bear did a lot of damage to the spikes here, actually.
Where'd you go, Giraffe?
I'm outside.
Are
I
you
mean,
already?
This would probably be the best place for a base in this area, if you wanted an additional base. There's lots of places to explore, still.
Us?
How'd you get Diagon? Out? Like, you get out, you went out.
Yeah, I jumped out where we came through.
Oh my goodness.
I thought that you had left.
Sort
That's
of,
I
came.
Going.
Yeah, okay, no, cool. Carry on. That's
I was finished in there.
Cool.
Parts, pistol barrel.
What's that down
nice.
There?
With the pistol book, we can actually make pistols.
Straight ahead there, what is nice. That? What's that building?
This one is...
Can't see it.
Foods.
Ah.
Can't weigh foods.
There we go.
Old Shamway.
There's food.
And I think I already broke in somewhere.
Hello,
lady. Maybe I haven't broken into this one.
There's more than one?
I guess I haven't.
What?
I broke into, like, a pharmacy somewhere.
That's cool.
Like.
And the bank.
Alright, I'll let them bang on this door here.
I just walked into the bank.
I'll just let them bang on this door here.
So you said it came south of the base?
Yeah, south. You that, like, in line with that watering hole, so you can keep going.
Alright. If it's in line with that watering hole, then I will definitely be running across it here shortly.
Promise maybe seeing it. If it's the city biome, it's kind of gray everywhere, so it's hard to see.
Oh yeah, I know.
Not nice and white like the snow biome.
Oh.
But it's always funny when you find drops later, like what you didn't get before, and you just kind of run across them.
It's totally happened to me twice this week with the other game.
Funny. We know there's one in the hub city somewhere. There's a drop in there. That's how we found it, as we're going after a drop.
Funny. Found another cave. Do they spawn like a zombie near cave, like the crates ever? Is that something that happens normally?
No.
Because I've always seen at least one zombie near every crate I've ever found, and I just wondered if it was a coincidence.
That's because you're going into a new area, and so it's spawning the zombies for the new area. Because it's usually the crate usually drops somewhere where you haven't been yet.
Gotcha. Yeah.
And that's why. But though I would think the noise of the airplane plane should attract zombies, right?
Yeah. I think I may have missed it. A lot of random crap out here. You're absolutely right.
Or you didn't go far enough yet.
That's a possibility, too.
It was diagonal from there. Like, it was more southeast from that hole, so... If you head, like, towards that cemetery, it should be in that line.
That it? That is it.
There you go. Yeah.
Well, that's not it. Damn it. That was a pile of bricks.
Okay.
It looked really...
Yeah.
A lot like a crate
but
to
where you are now, it should be in that area where you are now.
That's where I've been looking for it.
Oh, I see. Yeah.
Like, I remember the days that the crates always used to have the plume all the time, so you could see them. And I wish that was back, because now they're really hard to find. There are times you'd log in and you'd see, like, six plumes up in the distance.
Huh.
Not anymore.
Lady, shut up. You're rude.
Do you want to go towards that store or that store? I'm not sure which one's which, but they both have signs.
Maybe we'll stumble upon it someday.
Here's a drinks and shakes place, too. There's a zombie nearby.
Always zombies nearby. They're so cute. It's so cray.
Working stiff pools. Oh, this is where the zombies attacked me, and I ran away.
Oh, there's a couple of
legs.
And clay.
Leg. Come on, buddy, you can make it home.
Ah! Broke my leg!
I'm gonna actually use this thing here.
Okay, for breaking legs. I'll be actors.
It looks like in the workbench there's more blocks you can build too. Because there's like some Adobe stuff that I don't
Oh, cool.
Be in a normal. So there might be more stuff you can build.
Be awesome, actually.
Like more decorative stuff. Oh no, you can build on yourself too. Never mind. I just never noticed them before.
You always know when you're getting close to home when nothing. When you find a lot of empty things.
Yeah.
Like, ah, I'm almost home.
Oh, there's a leather hood schematic. That's not that exciting.
Oh, and the workbench is a lot faster, too.
Sorry, lady. That was rude.
Crafting stuff. Okay. Right.
I shot her right in the whistle, and she didn't have nothing. Hey, untouched cooler. I touch you. Oh, I can't do anything with it. My hands are full. I'm really, really anxious about going back into my single player game, considering the types of gameplay that I've had lately. I'm like, oh. Yeah. I mean, you don't play 7 Days to Die to relax, I would say. You don't. It's not the type of game you play unless you are high level and have everything you need, but you know. And you can just pretty much blow people away and you have plenty of defenses. That's different. But generally, you know, you expect a little bit of tension when you're playing 7 Days to Die, and it's just a little bit much. A little bit much now. Heck, I brought those gun parts for you, by the way.
Alright, cool. I gotta wait for that book before I get in.
The shotgun parts?
Oh, shotgun parts, okay.
Yeah, I got shotgun parts and a shotgun stock.
Oh, I found a gun.
Yeah. Oh man.
The toilet gun.
So what's in this chest?
Okay. My inventory is too full.
Iron pickaxe in that one. Oh, you open that one, cool. No, it's untouched. Yeah, I'm full too. Shoot.
Got the chest.
BRB, grab some.
Yeah,
something.
I would have. Yeah.
Guess we're gonna probably have to head back towards base. Should we hit
so.
Up that chest first?
Yeah,
and
yeah
see
let's
if
do
we
that.
Carry any of it?
Let's
ooh, I just
do
found
that.
Two wrenches.
Ah, shoot. Yeah.
There you go.
I don't know what to drop.
Can you scrap anything to make slots?
I've already scrapped everything. Yeah. I guess I'll just leave the scrap.
Here, I can grab one.
Well, what's the scrap? If it's scrap
it,
iron.
Well,
no.
Brass.
We need that.
And,
okay, that's
and an iron arrowhead are the two things I was going to leave.
Yeah, okay.
There's still other things iron. In this place that we need to grab.
Well, that's why you have to drop our chest right in there to dump it all off.
Yeah, we're kind of far from it at this point, and we've put a lot in it.
So let's go back to the chest. I think it's to the
yeah,
east.
Yeah, because it's going to take us
yeah, well,
a little
go
bit
back.
Of time to get back to the base, too.
You guys are pretty far.
You can't pull out up there somewhere?
They probably could be able to make it back if they left now.
Yeah, but then they have to run all the way back to continue looting, right? If they can stay out there at night, that would be better, probably.
Would you want to find a place to camp out here somewhere?
Because if you're, like, on a roof somewhere... You know,
well, we have access to the roof of that fenced-in place.
So let's do that, I guess.
Is that this place right up here? Yeah.
Yeah.
We should still stop at that chest.
No, for sure.
We can still loot, actually, because it's only...
Yeah,
only
six.
Yeah, no.
Yeah.
So I'm just going to drop off stuff in the chest. And...
All the way at the end of this road?
Yeah, all the way at the end of this road.
Times they be crazy, man. Bring in some more
right
sand.
There.
Hey, Adrian Ranches.
Another.
And hello, Clara. Why not use a grill to cook the meat?
You don't need
because
to anymore.
Grills don't cook meat anymore.
They changed it.
Grills do not cook meat anymore, Clara.
Only baked potatoes.
Alpha 14. Things have changed, fortunately.
Yep.
I'm just dumping like all my stuff in here, basically that.
Yeah.
Throw those. Throw that in there. that. Sorry, this is a lot of stuff.
Goodness, we have a lot of iron. Got a lot of iron here, mate.
Keeping the engines on me because I want to bring those back. That's I should keep that book on me too, but
I was just looking to see if I can like grab anything.
I'm just dumping everything I have in there and then on the way back, yeah.
Alright. What way? This way since we
Yeah, go the other way, exactly, yeah. Exactly that way, yeah.
Recipes. Cold water now. Gonna cook up that hair water.
You can actually use the goldenrod to cook it up into goldenrod tea if you want now. Because we got everything planted that we're gonna have planted.
That's interesting,
for
right?
For now.
It's like a block of nothing, but the road keeps going this way as if it is part of the town.
Theirs, isn't it?
Oh, I'm level 22 now. Woohoo! Don't know why.
Woo! Level am I?
And this is kind of like. It's just weird that there's like.
Level 12.
This stuff.
Okay, so now we have to decide if we're going to stay through to the day 14 horde or not, because it's 10:15 here now.
Yeah.
And if you guys can't stay, that'd be like another extra hour or so. If you can't stay that long, we should stop here, not on the actual day 14.
Exactly, yeah, I agree. I think, that means we'll have to be on a rooftop somewhere.
Oh yeah, that's right. You guys are really close to getting back.
So if you want, you take me to that spot that's safe, and we'll log off there, I guess.
Or do you want to try to run back to the base? Yeah,
the chances are the horde
will
probably end up coming here.
I think we're too far out to the base.
Yeah, it's too far out. It's too late now.
I don't want to log off. Like, I don't want to have to shut down the server on day 14.
Yeah, no, exactly. I agree.
Right?
So they're just trying to decide whether or not they wanted to come back here or not. Also,
well, the horde
it's not going to work out.
Night anyways, right? So they still have the day of 14 to loot.
But we want to log out
loot,
you know, now, though, right? Yeah. Basically, is what you're saying.
Well, that's what I'm saying. I'm saying if you guys can stay another hour, then we're fine. If you can't, then we have to log out now. Yeah.
Well, I can stay the hour. It all depends if our wonderful.
Everyone else. Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm getting kind of wiped out. It's been.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's just me personally. You should go somewhere safe and then log off.
And then I should be able to come back and be here before the horde next week, because that's scheduled on the, what is it, the 8th? No, the 24th, right?
Be 7 days, basically, from today.
Yeah.
Math, not my strong point. We play 7 days every 7 days.
The math is not my strong point either, right? So don't worry.
Yeah. I have a planner. I write everything down in my planner. Alright guys, well it looks like we're going to probably wrap up the stream at this point, at least on my end. So thank you very much all of you guys who came out to watch us play since 7 Days to Die multiplayer. If you are interested in watching us take on the Horde on day 14, we will be playing 1 week from today in 7 days.
You bet.
Getting together, what, 8 o'clock Eastern time, right? 8 p.m. Eastern?
6 p.m. Mountain.
Correct.
Yeah.
Six Mountain. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. All right. Cool. Well, I'm gonna end the stream here. So
bye,
take
guys.
Care, guys.
You.
Have a wonderful night.
Bye, Jesus. Stream.
Hey, bye.
We killed it already. It's done.
All right. So we're logging off here, I guess.
Yeah.
Yeah, I guess so.
I think so. I'm just up here because it's safer. I jumped up from that wooden or that metal thing onto the.
Yeah, I watched you.
Yeah. It's parkouring.
Yeah, I don't think my splinted leg can handle that.
Okay.
Yeah,
cool.
That's true.
I have a splinted leg, too, so anyways.
Oh.
I'm going to hit quit here, then.
I'll just be here.
We'll be fine, because it's nothing.